Good morning, students. Now, today we will continue with the numericals based on unit cells and other calculations based on unit cells. Yesterday we talked about crystal lattice and unit cell. Now we will calculate the contribution of atom at, first let us talk about corner. Now there are 8 corners, right? There are 8 corners. So the contribution of atom at corner is 1 by 8 because an atom which is present at the corner is shared by 8 other unit cells. So this is how we calculate the contribution. Basically, we are telling ki how much this particular atom will be shared. So it is shared by 8 unit cells. That is the meaning of contribution. Now we talk about face. An atom that is present by face, it is shared by, there are 6 faces, it is shared by only 2 unit cells. It's shared by 2 unit cells. So we talk, we say there are 8 corners, there are 6 faces, and an atom which is present at face, it is shared by 2 unit cells. So what will be the contribution? It will be 1 by 2. Now an atom which is present at the body center, obviously it will not be shared by any other unit cell. So the contribution will be 1. How many edges are there? Edges in a unit cell? There are 12 edges in a unit cell. And it will be shared by 4 other unit cells. Shared by 4 unit cells. So what will be the contribution? It will be 1 by 4. Now let us calculate the number of atoms per unit cell. Right? In FCC, in BCC and in simple cubic. Simple cubic is primitive unit cell. Now number of atoms per unit cell, let us calculate in all the 3 systems, and it is represented by Z. So don't get confused. In other chapters and in other chemistry till now, we represent Z by atomic number, but here Z is represented by number of atoms per unit cell. So first let us calculate for simple cubic. Now in simple cubic, atoms are present only at corners. And I told you that there are 8 corners, and what is the contribution of each atom at a corner? It is 1 by 8. So how many atoms will be there? 1. Now we calculate for face-centered cubic. Face-centered cubic, that is FCC. Now where are the atoms present in FCC? They are present at corners as well as faces. So we have already done that there are 8 corners and contribution at corner is 1 by 8. There are 6 faces, contribution is 1 by 2. So it comes out to be 4. So that means for simple cubic, Z is equal to 1, and for FCC, Z is equal to 4. Then we talk about body centered cubic, that is BCC. So BCC, I told you that atoms are present at corners as well as body center. So it will be 8 into 1 by 8 plus 1, which comes out to be 2. So Z for BCC is 2. Because we will be using this in the numericals for calculating the number of unit cells in a particular system. Okay, now let us discuss the numerical. Now the first question, let us say sodium crystallizes in BCC. We have to calculate the number of unit cells. A in 9.2 gram of sodium. And what is the atomic mass of sodium? It is 23. Of sodium is 23. Now, what is the formula to calculate the number of unit cells? Let us solve this numerical. So, number of unit cells is equal to moles into N0 upon Z. Now, what is Z here? Z is the number of atoms per unit cell. And what is N0? N0 is Avogadro's number, 6.02 into 10 to the power 23. So, now when we calculate the moles, it is given mass by the atomic mass. Let us make the substitutions. So, it will be 9.2 upon 23 into 6.02 into 10 to the power 23 upon what is Z? Z for BCC, it is 2. So, what will be the answer? When you solve this numerical, your answer will come out to be 1.2044 into 10 to the power 23 unit cells. So, it's clear. We just have to apply this formula and then we have to substitute. Now, we'll solve a numerical related to FCC. Gold crystallizes in FCC. Calculates the number of unit cells. In 2 milligram of gold. And what is the atomic mass of gold? It is 197. Now again, we'll apply the formula. I told you the formula to calculate the number of unit cells. You can also do it yourself now. So it will be moles into N0 by Z. So how do we calculate the moles? Given mass, 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 3 upon molar mass, 197 into 6.02 into 10 to the power 23. And what is Z for FCC? We have already calculated. It is 4. So, our answer will come out to be 1.528 into 10 to the power 18. So, this is our answer after solving. Now, we will do some numericals related to BCC, FCC, wherein we have to find out the formula of the compound. So, we say that in a compound, what is happening? In a compound, X atoms are present at corners. And Y atoms are present at alternate faces. So we have to tell the formula of the compound. So what will be the formula? Now let us calculate. Now X is present at corners. How many corners are there? 8. And what is the contribution? It is 1/8. Now, Y atoms are present at alternate faces. Now, what is the common mistake that you do? You say that there are 6 faces, so alternate faces will be 3. But now, let us look at the cube. If this is one face, then alternate face is this. If this is one face, alternate face is this. So, how many alternate faces are there? Alternate faces are 2. So, 6 into 1/2. So, what will be the formula? When you solve, it will be XY3, right? Oh, sorry. So, there are two alternate faces. Wait. there are two alternate faces. Now we will not take 6, we will take 2. X is equal to 8 into 1 by 8. So it is 1, 2 alternate faces, it is 1. So it will be xy. So formula of the compound will be xy. Now let us take the next question, wherein we say that A atoms are present at corners, B atoms are present at faces, and C atoms are present at edges. Now what is the formula of this compound? So 8 into 1 by 8, how many faces? 6 into 1 by 2, how many edges? 12 into 1 by 4, contribution at edge is 1 by 4, so it will be 1, 3 and 3. So formula will be AB3C3. Okay, now suppose there is a question in which they say that one of the atoms is missing. So this is also an important question. Suppose I say that atoms A are present at corners, but one atom is missing. One atom is missing. And atoms B are present at faces, and we have to derive the formula. So how are we going to derive the formula? Now A will be 7 into 1 by 8. Why 7 into 1 by 8? Because one atom is missing. There are 8 corners, and if one atom is missing, then it will come out to be 7. So contribution will become 7 by 8. Now what about B? B are present at faces. 6 into 1 by 2. So this will be 3. So when we take the ratio A is to B, it will be 7 by 8 is to 3. So this will come out to be A 7, B 24. So this will be the formula of the compound. Now I'll tell you how to find out the edge length in simple cubic, FCC and BCC. I hope these numericals are clear, so you can practice more numericals of this type from NCERT. Okay. Now we'll calculate the relationship between radius and edge length for different types of systems, right? Radius and edge length for cubic systems, we'll calculate the relationship between them. So first let us take simple cubic. Now we have already studied that atoms in simple cubic, they are present only at corners, right? Ab ye dikhne mein aisa dikh raha hai that the atoms are farther apart, but it's not like that. Atoms are actually touching each other. Now edge length is represented by small a and radius is represented by small r. Now this system is actually represented like this. So if this is A and the radius is R and R, so that means A is equal to 2R. For simple cubic, what will be the relation? A is equal to 2R. Now let's derive the relation for FCC. Now in FCC, let us understand where are the atoms present and how they are present. So let's see. One atom is here, one atom is here, one atom is here, right? And one atom is on the face. Okay. Now this is the face diagonal. This is, let's say this is A, this is B, and this is C. Now ABC is a right angled triangle. What is AB? AB is equal to A, that is the edge length is A. BC is also A, edge length is A. So BC is also A. Now what about AC? We'll have to apply Pythagoras theorem because it is a right angle triangle. So what is AC? AC is equal to root 2A because we are applying Pythagoras theorem here. It's a right angle triangle. ABC is a right angled triangle. Now that means face diagonal. AC क्या है? It is the AC is equal to face diagonal. Now in FCC the atoms at face diagonal they are touching each other. Corners के atom तो touch करते ही हैं, but face diagonal atoms they are touching each other. So now let us understand. AC is equal to root 2A and AC is also equal to, from here we understand that this is R, this is 2R and this is also R. So that means this is equal to 4R. So root 2A is equal to 4R. So what is the relationship? A is equal to 4R by root 2, right? So A is equal to 4R by root 2 from here. Or we can say R is equal to root 2A by 4. So depending upon whatever is asked in the numerical, now we will derive the relationship for BCC. Now let us see BCC, that is body-centered cubic. Now let's see. In BCC, atoms are present at corners as well as in the body center. So here we will have to take the body diagonal. Now let's see. So let's say one atom is here. So we will take this ABC like this. Now let's see. This body diagonal is AB. Okay, AB is the body diagonal here. Now BC edge length is A. BC is equal to A. But AC here, again, now see, this is the face diagonal. AC, this is the face diagonal here. So what will be AC equal to? We just calculated AC is equal to root 2A. And what about BC? It is equal to A. Now since ABC is a right angle triangle, so we will again apply Pythagoras theorem. So we will say that AB will be equal to under root 3A. We are applying Pythagoras theorem, right? So AB will come out to be under root 3A. We will take a square plus under root 2a ka square and then we will take the square root of that. So it will come out to be under root 3a. So body diagonal AB is equal to this and atoms in the body diagonal, they are also touching each other. So this will be R, this will be 2R and this will also be R. So that means root 3a is equal to 4R. So A will be equal to 4R by root 3. So this is a relationship for BCC and we will apply these formulas in the numericals. Now we will talk about how to find out the density of unit cell. We will talk about density of unit cell. So cubic system ki we have to find out the density. Now how do we do that? If we are given suppose any, let's see the density formula. We say density formula density is represented by rho is equal to Z into M upon n naught into a cube. This is the symbol for density. Generally, density is given in gram per centimeter cube. Now, we have to understand what are all these terms. Z is equal to number of atoms per unit cell. So, it is equal to number of atoms per unit cell. And M is equal to atomic or molar mass depending upon whether element is given or compound is given. So it is atomic or molar mass. What about N naught? N naught is Avogadro's number, 6.02 into 10 to the power 23. And A is equal to edge length. Now, generally, edge length is given in picometer. So, we have to be careful. If A is in picometer, then what we will do? The formula will become Z into M upon N naught into A cube into 10 raised to the power minus 30. Because we will have to convert it into centimeter. That is why we will take this term 10 raised to the power minus 30. Because A ka cube hai yahan pe. And what is the relationship? How we convert picometer to centimeter? We multiply by 10 raised to the power minus 10. So, numericals on the basis of this formula, we will be discussing in the next class. Meanwhile, you can solve the questions related to whatever we have done and you can study this